So this evening we're going to speak about the importance of the devotee care within our society.
今天晚上我们要来讲一下关于我们协会里面的照顾奉献者的情况。
Right, we want to see more devotees and happier devotees.
我们希望有更多的奉献者，而且是快乐的奉献者。
More devotees.And happier to work.
更多的奉献者，更快乐的奉献者。
Right, so sometimes, just like within a temple, there are many different departments. You know, someone's in charge of finances, someone's looking after the deity worship, someone's taking care of the accounting.
就好像每一个庙里有很多的部门，有人是照顾神像，有些人是做照顾这个。财务有些照顾说其他的啦，厨房或什么的。
So, sometimes it's pointed out we need to also have somebody take care of the devotees.
所以有时候有人就指出呢，我们也必须要来照顾奉献者这个部分。
Sorry, Mama. Do you need the mic? Well, not really. Not a very big room. She has a big voice. I have a big voice.
How are you?
It's a long ship in here. Okay, so caring for devotees is something which we find also is referred to in the scriptures also.
在关于照顾奉献者里面呢，经典也有相关的部分。
We see examples of how Shivananda Singh every year would bring devotees.From Navadvip to Jagannath Puri or Rath Yatra.
我们看到 Shivananda Sen 呢，他就是每一年带了多少奉献者从 Navadvip 到了这个 Jagannath Puri.
And he would take care of them for the journey. He would arrange their food, their lodging.
而且他也照顾他们的饮食啦，住宿。
And he would arrange their transportation. They had to cross the rivers and cross different state borders.
他也安排他们的这些交通啊，要怎么样穿过这个国界，还有这个说过河这一些交通。
So he was taking care of the devotees under his, who would come with him, who joined the party, who were traveling with him. He was taking the responsibility to look after them.
所以呢，他是扛起这个责任来照顾奉献者。
And then when they came to Jagannath Puri, then Lord Chaitanya was also concerned that they should be properly, their accommodation should be properly arranged.
当他们来到 Jagannath Puri 的时候呢，主 Chaitanya 是很关心的，就认为这些也是要得到好好的照顾。
They should have nice.Prasadam, make sure they got Jagannath Prasadam and they should be looked after.
他确定了他们要得到好的 Prasadam 啊，特别是在 Jagannath Puri 这个 Jagannath 的 Prasadam 啊，大家要得到好好的照顾。
And similarly, Srila Prabhupada was also concerned for devotees.
同样的，圣伯夸也是关心奉献者。
There are examples of devotees who were.Serving Srila Prabhupada, and Srila Prabhupada would notice some bile or some infection on their body, and Srila Prabhupada would be concerned about it.
像呢，包括在的时候呢，他也是关心，就是说，当奉献者服务圣包括的时候，包括也看到奉献者的情况，比方说有人身上啊哪里起了脓包啦，发水泡啦，包括觉得说你们这些也是要好好的去处理照顾。
Of course, the scope of devotee care is, it becomes quite broad. There are many different aspects of devotee care. We want to try and have a look at some of them this evening.
所以呢，关于照顾奉献者有很多的方面，我们今天晚上来看一下。
But you can see here, mentioning something about what are we trying to achieve by having this kind of devotee care?
我们来看一下呢，关于照顾奉献者想要完成或是达到的情况。
Mentioned here first of all that every devotee should be spiritually happy.
这里提到，每一个奉献者都应该是灵性上快乐的。
Prabhupada had one servant, person who was personally serving, personally accompanying Srila Prabhupada and giving him personal service, and Prabhupada noticed he was not happy.
那有一个人呢，他亲自在服务的 Prabhupada， 那 Prabhupada 有注意到这个人他是不快乐的。
In fact, he was morose. Morose means miserable.
事实上，那个人是愁眉苦脸。这个意思就是说呢，他觉得好像生活有很悲惨或痛苦的事。
So Srila Prabhupada, when Srila Prabhupada noticed this, he said to him that you cannot be in Krishna consciousness. You're not Krishna conscious when you are morose.
所以 Prabhupada 说的，你是不可能是 Krishna 知觉的，因为 Krishna 知觉的人呢，不会是愁眉苦脸的。
Right? In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says in the 18th chapter, Brahma Bhuta Prasanatma. Right? And he's saying that one who knows that we are Brahman, that we are not the body, but rather we're spiritual beings, then he is a joyful soul.
就像 Krishna 在国家梵歌的第十八章里面说到呢，如果一个人是在这个 Brahman 超然的层面里面，灵魂的层面呢，他是快乐的，因为他不是在这个物质身体的层面。
Yeah, we feel relief to think that I'm not the body.
因为如果我们知道我们不是这个身体的时候，我们会觉得很大的舒缓。
On the contrary, I'm a spiritual particle, which is part and parcel of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
相反的呢，我们是至尊人格守神的所属的一个小部分。
And so, if that is Krishna, this is the beginning of Krishna consciousness, to understand that we have an eternal relationship with Krishna.
这是 Krishna 知觉的开始，就是说我了解我们跟 Krishna 有着永恒的关系。
And so, we should be concerned to see that people have this kind of consciousness.
对，我们要必须关心人们是有那样的知觉。
Right, we come to Krishna consciousness to awaken this kind of consciousness.
我们来到 Krishna 知觉运动，就是要来唤醒这样的知觉。
To give up the pains and the misery of material life.
来放弃呢物质世界的悲哀痛苦。
And we see also, if you read the Nectar of Devotion, which Srila Prabhupada has given us, then it describes how immediately on taking up Krishna consciousness, we should feel relief from material distress.
在奉爱的甘露里面也说到，当我们接受了 Krishna 知觉，我们应该可以感到马上的这样的舒缓。
If we're not feeling relief from material distress, must be doing something wrong.
假如我们没有从物质的痛苦悲哀去缓解出来的话，表示有不对劲的地方。
We're not chanting properly, or we're not hearing, we're not doing proper service.
就可能是我们没有念恰当的念诵，或者我们在服务方面没有做得恰当。
So we want to encourage people. We want to try to see that the devotees are actually spiritually happy.
所以我们要鼓励人们，而且我们要想到奉献者是真正快乐的。
That's only one aspect of devotee care, though.
所以这是在关心奉献者的一部分。
We want to see that they're also materially well situated.
同时，我们也想要看到他们在物质方面是所以处境是恰当的。
Now, that's, of course, it's not going to be the same for everyone.
当然，对每个人来讲就不一定是一样的。
Just like in the Vanashram system, there are Brahmins who are generally poor.
就好像在美国的社会阶层的制度里面，一般的灵性阶层呢，婆罗门一般是说比较物质贫穷。
And some people, of course, they're business minded, they're Vaishya. So generally, they enjoy more material objects.
那生意人是属于 Vaishya 这个阶层，一般来讲，他们是比较有多的物质上的舒适或享受。
And worker, the working class, then they're differently situated.
啊，工作阶层、劳动阶层，他们的处境又不同。
But we do the purpose of devotee care. In devotee care, we do want to be concerned about the material situation of the devotee.
所以啊，在对奉献者的关怀之中，也是要看到奉献在物质上呢，也是很恰当的立身。
And they're going to identify. They should feel that ISKCON as a member, as a devotee of ISKCON, a follower of ISKCON.That ISKCON generally cares, that they're concerned about me.
所以希望呢追随 ISKCON 的人呢参与 ISKCON 的人呢会感觉就是说这个协会也是会关心我的。
There are many aspects of Krishna consciousness.
在 Krishna 知觉是有很多方面的。
Devotee care is one aspect, one aspect of Krishna consciousness.
照顾奉献者也是Krishna 知觉的一个部分。
And we've mentioned here, each devotee that they should look at, they should feel the responsibility to look after their own needs.
那就是每一个奉献者有责任去照顾自己生活上的必须。
Now that will be on in different levels, physically, mentally.Spiritually,
那这在很多的不同的层面的，有灵性上的、身体上的，还有其他方面的。
If we haven't taken care of our own self, then how would we ever be able to take care of others?
假如我们自己没办法照顾自己的话，我们怎么能够照顾别人？
So very important is first of all take care of our own self.
所以这是非常重要，首先要先照顾自己。
That's not selfish.
这种
just practical.
这种情况不是自私，而是实际。
And then, secondly, we say that they can easily and successfully seek qualified help from the society.
同时也是希望呢，人成员们可以很容易找到有资格的帮助啊，权威的资格的帮助。
Now, asking for help, you know, we shouldn't feel that, oh, no, I don't like to ask people for help. No. Of course, it's not that we just come and ask people only for money. You know, there's a lot of other help besides just giving people monetary, solving the monetary problem.
所以呢，去要求帮助呢，有很多方面，而不是只是说跟人家要钱帮忙。
But we do generally need help. We need to have somebody to open up to discuss our problems with.
我们一般需要找到适恰当的人来跟我们讨论呢，跟他们讨论啊，揭发我们的心意啦。
So it's important that we have some problem.We may not be able to solve the problem ourselves. It's good to be able to take help from somebody.
所以呢，这是很重要的，就是有些时候我们也有没有办法解决问题的时候，我们要去找可以帮忙解决的。
And then continues, goes on, number C there, that we want to also be concerned about others.
再跟着就是说我们也希望照顾自己之外可以延伸去照顾到别人。
So this is the vision which is recommended for devotee care.
这是我们在奉献关怀奉献者的愿景。
We begin with ourselves.
先从自己来开始。
We're not able to help ourselves, we ask for help.
假如自己没办法做到自助的话就要去求助他人。
And then we want to extend to others.
再来去延伸去帮助别人。
And then the mission of devotee care to ensure the Vaishnava virtue of care is there in all aspects of the ISKCON society.
然后我们也希望呢保证在整个 ISKCON 的奉献者的社会里面呢所有的这个照顾奉献者可以延及到各层面。
know, people should feel that they really have some shelter, that people are caring for them.
他们应该真正感觉到他们得到庇护，而且被关心的。
And to provide different services for spiritual, emotional, physical, and social well-being.
然后呢，这个协会可以提供各种服务，包括灵性上的、情感情方面，还有身体跟社会的利益啊，社会福祉方面。
So this is for all the members of ISKCON.、嗯、
这是啊、在 ISKCON 里面成员的一个使命。
Of course, there are many different.Levels of members of ISKCON.
当然，在 ISKCON 里面也有很多不同层次的成员。
We'll look at that in a little while.
我们一会儿之后会再看那个。
Okay, then, what the services? What kind of service should devotee care provide?
那关于关照奉献者的服务有哪一些？
Somebody who's looking after the devotees, generally caring for the devotees, then they must cooperate with the leadership, meaning like the management group, the devotees who are overseeing the affairs of the center.
关于照顾奉献者方面呢，也要跟这个管理领导呢互相合作支持，然后在这方面协调的进行。
You know, some people are busy organizing big programs and arranging the visits of different people coming to the center. They don't have time to look into the individual needs of different devotees often.
比方说呢，有些奉献者常常在他专注在这个办联络啊，进行这个大的活动，所以一般而言呢，他比较没有那些时间去照顾个别奉献者的细节。
There's so many things they have to be thinking about. They have to make there's nobody to do the puja. There's not enough people in the kitchen. Nobody cleaned up, and the neighbors are a problem.
比方说了就说有没有人去做神像服务啦？厨房的人手够不够啦？之后打扫啦，或者说邻居的意见呐，这些都需要注意到的。
So, in addition to all these things, you know, we have to also be thinking about devotees, the different devotees, any problems which may come up.
除了那一些常态性的要去注意到各个部门的情况呢，我们也要去注意到。每一个个别奉献者的处境。
And taking care of the devotees is one person's job, but at the same, he should have that, you know, one person that these people who are concerned with devotee care, they want to encourage all the other different centers and departments also to be concerned about caring for the devotees.
所以照顾奉献者呢，好像是一个人去照顾一个人得到照顾，但是我们希望就是说，除了被照顾人之外，我们还可以再延伸，让被照顾人可以再继续去照顾别人。
Mm-hmm. And also support projects which are concerned with devotee care.
然后同时支援呢那一些照顾奉献者这个部分的计划。
And sure, like in Melbourne, big center like Melbourne, where my mind is coming from.You have a devotee care department there, probably. Maybe. You wouldn't know.
No. I don't think so.
You don't need any care. Okay, so devotee care is something which is important, and it's something which people need to.And you know, when you have a devotee care department, then you would generally want to inform the devotees about it, let them know there is a devotee care department, then you have a problem, you can go there, then maybe they can help you.
当有了照顾奉献者的部门呢，你们也会希望说去通知大家，让他们知道说如果有什么事情啊，什么问题啊，可以在这个部门去寻求諮商跟协助。
And there has to be.Training and education, people who are doing devotee care, they have to be able to, they should know how to respond and how to act in different situations.
然后照顾奉献者呢，也的人呢，必须也有得到训练培养，因为他要知道在什么样不同的情况，怎么样处理这一些不同的事物。
They have to be in touch with the devotees. They have to know what's going on in the lives of devotees.
啊，这些人必须跟奉献者保持联系，要知道他在他发生的事情跟情况。
And they should know about.They should have like a database of different information, resources, things which they can come back on to use to help people in their difficulties.
然后呢，他们要储存资料库，把所有的这些情况、细节啊，这资料存下来，然后在什么样的情况都可以应用到。
As we get more devotees and more people, mean more problems.
当我们呢？越多的奉献者加入的时候，就是人越多，问题就越多。
But we don't want to run away from problems.
但是我们并不是说要去逃避问题。
But rather we have to be thinking how to deal with these problems, how to help people solve these problems.
反而呢，我们是想说怎么样去帮助这些人呢？怎么样让他们帮他们解决问题？
So, You can see, we do have, in the recent years, we have been publishing literature about devotee care. Some different publications have come out.
最近几年呢，我们协会里面也出版了关于照顾奉献者的这一些书籍。
And we're trying to encourage more and more devotees to be aware of the need for these things.
那我们也想要鼓励奉献者去注意到这一些事。
Each area, each country, each zone or so, then they should have a devotee care department. They should have some resources. They should have some database information available.
每一个地区、每一个地方呢，都应该有这个奉献者的资料库，然后知道他们的情况。
We mentioned here that devotee care only indirectly includes outreach. Its focus is really more on devotees. We're not talking about, you know, anybody and everybody who just may casually come to the center, but we're talking about people who are actually devotees, who are practicing, who are connected.
当然我们说各方面来说，但是呢，我们照顾奉献者主要是对于规律的在这个奉献服务里面参与的人，而不是说外面啊或所有一切的人。我们基本上是关注在这个庙里面服务的奉献者。
And we're not referring to any of these particular projects, which may also be part of the temple, like Bhakti Briksha and counseling and so on. There's many different mentor systems.
我们说到呢。当然是照顾奉献者每个个别的奉献者，但是基本上不是说某一个特别的计划或群组，比方说奉爱树小组或什么，就是另外一件事了。
Here we're talking about care as a virtue, you know, it's a quality which we're offered, which should be there, and it's also a service.
对，我们说到照顾奉献者呢，是应该一种品德，是也是算是一个服务。
Devotee care, taking care of devotees is something which, we should naturally want to be concerned about.
去照顾奉献者应该是我们自己自然愿意去关心、注意的。
We mentioned here, we want to encourage devotees to.Recognize these principles of taking care of devotees.
我们希望奉献者去认出这一些原则，然后怎么样好好照顾奉献者。
And it works. Devotee care department has to work with all of the other different projects and centers and departments which are there in every temple.
那照顾奉献者同时要跟每一个中心、每个庙宇。 一起进行的。
So it's on both levels. There's the local level, you have taking care of devotees on a personal level, individual, and then you're working maybe in a particular locality, and then also working on an institutional level.
那就有很多的不同的层面，有一些是单一个人的层面，那有一些呢是所谓某一个地区性的情况这种层面。
Just like ISKCON is an institution, it's a big society, worldwide society. We're not just one little center.
就像 ISKCON 是一个很大的协会，一个组织，不是一个小小的中心而已。
And so the activities of ISKCON are all related to the institution.
所以ISKCON 里面的活动都是跟我们整个组织是相关联的。
And at the same time, we're here in Taiwan. We're affected by different governmental policies, national policies.
那我们在这里呢，台湾也是有当本地政府的政策啦，或各种情况相关系的。
You get new laws coming out from time to time.
有时候呢
government may change policies.
有时候一段时间一段时间政府也有新的法律法令出来。
Right, Nimai was telling me about Australia, how they've got this new policy that you come with a religious visa, you can only stay 2 years.
像Nimai跟我说，像现在呢，在澳大利亚呢，如果有所以得到了这个。宗教人士的这种签证呢，现在只允许停留两年。
Previously, devotees had been staying for a long time there. So many, they brought many devotees from other countries there to help to do service in the different centers.
那以前呢，就是你这个是宗教人士的签证呢，可以住很久，然后呢，也可以带人啊，帮忙啊，做了很久。
So.In Australia, for example, they have a lot of activities, particularly food distribution, catering, and restaurants, and temples, and deities. So they brought a number of devotees from South America.
像澳大利亚呢，澳洲有很多的这个活动跟进行的节目，像那个生命之粮啦，还有就是说奉献者做餐饮的外汇。还有很多固定常态在进行的很多的活动，所以呢，他们就需要很多人手。那这个庙宇就让很多的南美洲的奉献者去到澳洲来做这一些工作跟服务。
But now they have visa after 2 years, then they have to go back to their country. They can't stay long.
但是现在的情况就是说。签证的条款改变了，他们只能留两年，所以呢，不能像以前那样很久的居留。
So that's a particular situation there in Australia.
这是在澳洲的一个很特别的情况。
And at the same time, there will be personal problems. Every individual will have their own personal problem.
那同样呢，每一个个人呢，会发生有个人需要处理的情况或问题。
And then, as I said, on the institutional level, there may be some policies within ISKCON which affect devotees.
然后还有有时候是组织性的政策或规则，有时候在 ISKCON 也有一些管理组织的政策的调整，可能会影响每个奉献者之类的事情。
Just like they instituted this disciple course, the people taking initiation, they have to all take the disciple course before the initiation.
就好像启迪的这一项，就是每一个要接受启迪人都必须有接受过门徒课程上过的，通过的。
So taking care of devotees, you can see, becomes very complex. Then you have to consider all these different issues, institutional wise.Local wise and personal.
所以呢，照顾奉献者就变得比较复杂了。你要想到，就是说，在全国的法令方面呢、个人方面呢、在组织方面的情况。
Okay, now we're going to look at the principles and values to mention these different things. What is this, the principles and values of devotee care?
那我们来看一下关于照顾奉献者的原则，还有它的价值。
So, there's this.Okay, principle, meaning the underlying universal truth that is required for successful application.
它这个原则呢，就是说，要成功的应用所需要的各种基本的、普遍的真理。
Just like in Krishna consciousness, we have regulated principles.
就好像我们在 Krishna 知觉里面也有那些规范守则。
So devotee care also, we have principles.
所以在照顾者奉献者方面，我们也有原则的。
And one of the principles is based on Vaishnava Seva.
其中的一个原则就是说，基础就是对 Vaishnava 奉献者的服务。
Yeah. We want to perform this activity of devotee care as a service for the devotee.
我们要进行这个关照照顾奉献者。这个事情是一个服务。
It's not meant to give trouble to the devotees, it's to help the devotees.
不是要给奉献者麻烦，是要帮助奉献者。
We come to, a devotee likes to give service. A devotee feels pleasure in serving other devotees.
我们是喜欢去服务，当我们喜欢服务奉献者，让奉献者取悦奉献者是一种快乐。
Of course, sometimes devotees are very I don't like to trouble anyone. I don't like to take service from anyone.
有时候有一些奉献者是比较保守害羞，他不喜欢去麻烦别人，不喜欢去吵到别人。
Just want to deal with my problems on my own and take care of my own problems.
因为只是想说只照顾自己，自己来处理自己的问题。
But we have to understand that sometimes there may be problems which we're not able to solve on our own. We need help.
但是我们要了解，有些时候有一些问题我们没有办法自己处理，我们需要得到帮助。
So this is sometimes something. Sometimes this is hard for people to accept.
所以有时候呢，这对有一些人来讲是很难接受的。
And if we're not willing to take help from others, then sometimes difficult to solve the problem.
在有一些情况，如果不愿意接受别人的帮助的时候，就会有问题的。
Of course, sometimes people are the other way, that they just simply want other people to deal with their problem. They don't like to solve the problem themselves.
但是相反的，有一些人又另外一个样子，他一直想找别人帮忙，他不想自己来处理。
So, it's difficult. You can understand. We should understand why the devotee care. Sometimes it's not a very easy thing. It's not so straightforward to just apply this principle. Taking care of others.
说到照顾奉献者，有时候不是一件容易的，是有时候很难说直接的就想要帮助别人，别人就会接受。
Then second thing, value.
That
meaning.Values, both personal, organizational, different virtues and dispositions.
所以呢，在价值方面呢，需要一个在个人方面，还有整个组织方面，个人的需要的品格，还有他的性情。
In giving devotee care, we should be able to exhibit these qualities when required. That there should be some.We should have some empathy, be able to show some feeling and appreciate concern for others.
所以当照顾奉献者，就是自然照顾别人，你要去关心到别人，要怜悯，去想到他的处境。
And then expertise, they should be trained, they should be skilled in performing the giving this kind of care.
同时也必须要是你有一个专长，或是要去训练出这个专长去照顾奉献者。
We had one. Did you have that devotee come here give a course on counseling? Did you have a course here? The one devotee, Ichvaku?
No.
From Mayapur. He was in Australia before, in Perth. you know him? Remember him? He's South American, but he lived in Aussie for a long time. And then he went to Mayapur. So he was trained in Australia as a counselor. And recently, you know, he's a full-time devotee now in Mayapur, so he came and gave a course in. He went around China and Hong Kong explaining counseling techniques.
Mm-hmm.
Rajalakshmi.
Yeah.
So expertise, gratitude, that devotee care also, we need help, we want to give help, we have to be able to show gratitude, appreciate others.
所以呢，我们要训练出这样子的专长，然后可以去欣赏到别人的处境啊，然后去同情他啦，这些需要的品质。
And sometimes being generous, showing generosity, being a generous, showing generosity.
而且呢，也要是慷慨大方。
So these are just some virtues and dispositions, qualities which may be required.
所以呢，这是一些。它的价值或是在它的品质上需要的。
And there has to be proper guidelines. You have to have good practice.
而且要有好的指导方针，而且要去练习那样的指导原则。
If you're going to take care of people, if you want to be involved in caring for devotees, we have to know how to take care of them, how to deal with people in different situations.
所以如果说要照顾奉献者，我们必须要知道，在说不同的情况下怎么去帮人。
You know, somebody comes and they're talking about their marriage problems. You have to know how to help them, how to deal with them.
如果真的有人来跟你询问请教关于怎么处理婚姻上的问题的话，你必须要有那个能力去了解，而且要有能力去帮助到别人，帮助到他们。
You have to give.Be able to give realistic, practical guidance to people. So that requires training.
就是要去训练，就是说可以对那些来寻求帮助的人，给他们实际的，而且是有用的帮助。
And then practice how to do these things. What way? How should we do this devotee care? What's our method of performing devotee care?
然后呢，去练习怎么样去实践这一些照顾奉献者的情况。
So we've mentioned some things, some ways in which we may, like having home programs, bringing people to your home or going to their home to look after them, see how they are. Maybe someone didn't come to the temple for a while, so we go and visit them.
那就是说有一些啊，比方说奉献者家里的拜访啦。或是在某一个人家里进行节目活动啦，或者说有一些呢，他有一段时间没来庙里，我们去他们家看一看，他是为什么什么事情，还是有什么问题不能来了。
Sometimes somebody may be in very poor health, they may even be dying. You know, you want to go to their home to kirtan for them.
还有有一些人可能很贫穷啦。或是病得很重啊，或是说在垂死边缘啊，可能就去那边帮他唱诵啊。
We just had one devotee leave the body in Vrindavan yesterday, Gunagrahi Swami.
昨天我们知道有一位奉献者 Gunagrahi Swami, 这位 Swami 昨天在 Vrindavan 离开躯体。
And so he'd been suffering from cancer for quite some time, a few years.
他得了癌症，痛苦了好几年。
And Govinda Maharaj described how this person, Gunagrahi Maharaj, was the one who made him a devotee.
那 Govinda Swami 就说呢，是这个 Gunagrahi Swami 呢，照顾他，让他成为奉献者。
So when this Gunagrahi Maharaj, while he was leaving the body there, the devotees from Vrindavan, they were doing non-stop kirtan for him.
当这 Gunagrahi Swami 呢，他就是在最后那段时间将死之前的那连续的好几个小时，Vrindavan 的奉献们 奉献者聚集在一起，一直为他唱颂。
And Govinda Maharaj said he was shouting the holy name into his ear.
那 Govinda Maharaj 就说呢，他在 Govinda Maharaj 的耳朵用大声的喊着 Krishna 的圣名。
And Maharaj, the Maharaj who was leaving the body, he was responding.
那 Govinda Maharaj Swami 呢，他就已经气已经越来越弱，要离开身体，但是他眼睛一直跟他回应，一直点着，一直点着。
So that's a nice way to depart from the world.
所以这样子的，在圣名的唱诵之中离开，是很好离开躯体的方式。
Govinda Maharaj chanting holy name in your ear.
你想想看，你如果在死亡那时候呢，有 Govinda Maharaj 在你耳朵唱诵主的圣名，是多么特别啊！
Very merciful.
Govinda Maharaj is 这么的仁慈。
This is devotee care.
这是照顾奉献者。
It's a very crucial time when you leave the body. And we will all have to leave the body one day.
这种时候呢是非常边缘状态了，很极端的危险的状态。就是要离开身体的，但是我实际上每个人早晚都会要离开这个身体的。
So part of the devotee care is doing this kind of care.
所以照顾奉献者的一个部分，也是说像这样的 care time。
And then for the system, we're talking about the different methods like bhakti briksha, counseling, and even hospice care.
那关于这个组织照顾奉献者有很多方面奉爱树的小组，还有就是说在关于医疗方面的照顾，还有就是说怎么样去关照他们日常生活这些照顾，还有諮商方面。
We want to be connected to the devotees somehow, so there are different methods by which we can be connected.
那我们都不管怎么样都希望跟奉献者互相关联连接，所以有一些方法。
And there's different structures also, different ways in which the system is, in which people are put, in which the organization works.
那这结构呢，也是可以有不同的方式，让奉献者在他不同的情况工作秩序的协调。
Yeah, we have a devotee care department. And he has to be accountable to the temple council. He has to tell the temple council what's happening, what's been the problem, what the problems are there.
所以照顾奉献者的架构里面呢，这个带领照顾奉献者的人必须是有足够的责任、负责任，而且要跟这个所谓庙宇或是当地的组织结构可以信任的人，可以依赖他去做这件事。
Sometimes the temple council are only looking, the festival's coming, oh, we have to buy this, oh, we have to do that to the temple, repair the building. You know, they don't know about the different devotees.
那有时候就说有大的节庆啦，那庙里都会就会就是说我们要买什么东西啦，什么东西要准备啦，或是要修理啦，装潢啦，但是他们不认识这些奉献者。
So devotee care is dealing with people, and it's people who are the most important thing.
那当然了，照顾奉献者的意思就是说跟人接触，那这个人呢是最重要的因素。
You can always get another building and repair the building and paint the building and stuff. But to get a devotee, you know, devotees are very, very rare, special. We need to take care of them.
你啊，房子啊，或什么东西坏了，可以再盖一个房子，再弄一个东西。但是奉献者是非常罕有的，你要培养出一个奉献者是很罕有的。
Okay, now we're going to speak about. We want you to understand these 12 principles and values, how they relate to devotee care.
我们要来谈到这十二个原则或者十二个价值是怎么样跟照顾奉献者相关联的。
Here's you can see the first one, Srila Prabhupada's teachings and example. Yeah, of course, taking care of devotees, it has to be according to Prabhupada's teaching and his example.
那照顾奉献者的前六项原则就是说，以 Prabhupada 的教导跟榜样模范，因为我们既然是奉献者，就要有奉献者的原则，是以 Prabhupada 的教导来做原则。
So taking care of the world, it has to be done by people who have some that they know the Red Prabhupada's books and they know about what Prabhupada's teachings are.
所以照顾奉献者呢，当然必须要知道有。研读经典啊，知道 Prabhupada 教导是什么，他才能知道要怎么样去照顾奉献者。
And this relates to wisdom and realization that they have some proper intelligence and realization, and they can apply these teachings and examples of Prabhupada into taking care of the devotees.
所以这个部分就需要有智慧，还有领悟，就是说他已经好好的研读 Prabhupada 的经典，然后他知道怎么样有责任的去照顾别人。
Then Vaishnava Seva and expertise go together.
所以呢，他这个原则还包括是心态是对 Vaishnava 的服务，而且他自己要培养出这种专长来照顾。
Serving devotees is very nice, but one has to know how to do it not properly for the full benefit for the care to really help the devotee to show care for the devotee.
当然照顾奉献者是非常好，但是要很恰当的进行，知道别人就是这个对方应该是要怎么样得到关照。
Let me mention loving relationships and affection and love.
再来就是说，这个是亲爱关心的感情。
Loving relationships described in our Upadeshamrita, Rupa Goswami describes six kinds of loving relationships.
关于奉献者之间的亲爱的关系 ，Rupa Goswami 在教诲的甘露讲到奉献者的关系的六个原则。
Somebody offers you some prasada, oh, I don't want that. No, I'm not going to eat that.
比方说，有人说给你 prasada 呢，你说我不要，我不吃这个。
I want cheesecake.
我想要那个 cheesecake 啊，奶酪蛋糕。
I want ice cream.
我要 ice 啊，冰淇淋。
So, there has to be proper affection and love in the dealing.
所以呢，在跟奉献者的交往是要很恰当的，有这个感情跟所谓感觉爱的感觉。
And then attentive listening and empathy. We want to some people are in difficulty. People have something to talk about. They really want to open up and try to tell us something.Oh, we don't listen, we use a mobile phone, you know. Oh, what do you say now? You know, you're listening to them, but at the same time, they have a phone in their hand, you know.
So, 要专注用心的聆听啊，同理心，就比方别人真的来跟我们说他的情况、困难啊、痛苦的时候，我们要用心去听啊，不是说啊，我在看着手机的啊，你说什么？
Just like you go to a meeting, you know, you have a meeting, you're thinking this meeting is really important, and other people are sitting looking at their mobile phones all the time, you know, and you're trying to talk to someone, you know, how will you feel? You know, it's not a very nice way to hear them.
所以呢，就好像去开会一样，你知道这个会议非常重要。那如果说你正要发言的时候，其他人又在看手机，你想想这是什么样的感觉？
So then, a sense of belonging, gratitude, generosity. Generally, we appreciate.
对呢，还有是正面方面积极的那种归属感，也是要有感恩、慷慨大方。
And then spiritual leadership and responsibility.
然后当然就是灵性的领导，而且是要责任的。
Okay, so, 对 Srila Prabhupada's teachings, very important for us.
啊，Prabhupada的教导对我们来讲是非常重要的。
If we don't know Prabhupada's examples, if we don't know Prabhupada's teachings, then how can we help people in Krishna consciousness?
假如我们不了解Prabhupada的教导的话，我们怎么样去做？Krishna 这些方式帮助别人。
And then, Vaishnava Seva is a very personal thing.
啊，对 Vaishnava 奉献者的服务是非常个人的。
Just like in family life, you know, the wife likes to give personal attention to take care of her husband.
就好像在家庭生活里面，这个太太会喜欢给丈夫一些关心啊。
And in this way, the husband becomes indebted and obliged to the service of the wife.
当这个情况下，那个丈夫会觉得他对老婆好像一种亏欠，他会更想要去照顾他的老婆。
And so similarly with Vaishnava Seva, taking service from a devotee, then a devotee feels very much obliged to that person.
所以呢，当一个奉献者接受到另外一个奉献者的照顾的时候，那个被照顾的奉献者会觉得他更想去回报。去义务性的回报那个照顾他的奉献者。
They give their blessings.
那照顾他的奉献者的人就会给他祝福。
Similarly, loving relationships. Sometimes in ISKCON, we don't always appreciate this kind of loving relationship.
再来关于亲爱的关系这种，有时候我们在 ISKCON 里面成员之间呢，不太有这亲爱的关系。
ISKCON was created for this purpose, actually, that there would be loving exchanges between the devotees.
ISKCON 其实它创建出来的是这个目的，就是要让奉献者建立这种亲爱的关系。
Okay, so spiritual leadership. We mentioned these three qualities that the leadership should be protective.Empowering and proactive. You can see PEP, spiritual PEP leadership.
所以灵性的领导呢，就有三个特质要做出来，就是用 PEP 英文的，他是非常先发主动的，然后他有能力给别人力量，就授权给别人。
Proactive.
Proactive, 就是先发主动的。
So, this is at all levels.
而且这个特质要展示在各个层次的。
You may think, well, I'm not a leader, I'm just an ordinary person, I'm just a worker. But everybody's a leader in this world.
那你也许会想说，我也不是一个领导，我只是一个普通的在工作的人。但是在 ISKCON 每个人都是一个领导。
Everybody's doing service for Krishna, so they're a leader.
每个人都在为 Krishna 做服务，每个人都是领导。
And we're meant to give protection to others. Protection doesn't mean you neglect them. It means you take care of them and you help them, you give them shelter.
所以一个领导代表的也是去保护别人，给他庇护，而不是说不管他，是要给他照顾，给他庇护。
Particularly the brahmanas and the cows and the women.
特别照顾到要是婆罗门啦，乳牛啦，妇女啊。
We don't have any cows here.
我们这里没有牛。
We don't have too many brahmins.
我们也没有太多婆罗门。
But we do have ladies and we.Well, children are not many here.
但是我们确实有很多女性人士。
But all of these people, they're supposed to be protected in the Vedic culture.
在韦陀文化里面呢，这一些都要得到保护。
Okay, so, going on I want to finish here tonight to speak about the areas of devotee care.
今天晚上我要讲到的部分有一个就是照顾奉献者的范围，它的层面。
Right, what particular areas are we thinking of?
我们在说的是哪一些，特别是指哪一些范围。
So first, we mentioned spiritual life.
首先我们讲到他的灵性生活，灵性生命。
What can be the problems?
在灵性生活里面可能存在什么问题？
We've mentioned some things.
我们说一些吧。
You know, somebody has doubts, they're not very convinced.
有一些人有疑问、疑惑，他觉得对哲理不太相信。
And some people, they lose faith. in the beginning they may be very enthusiastic, but something happens and they just lost, they lose their faith.
关于这个疑问的部分，就是有一些人刚开始他非常热诚来了，然后一段时间就有疑问，甚至没有信心来了。
Maybe in the beginning, you know, they were making a lot of money, and then they lose their money, and then lost my faith.
或者有一些来参之前赚了很多钱，成为修行的之人，之后没有赚钱，反而赔钱。
Or maybe the woman got a nice man, but then, you know, thought they had a problem with the man, and she lost the man, so she lost her faith.
或者有些女孩子呢，她碰到一个所谓好的男子，然后呢，后来啊，发生关系啊，结婚啊，后来跟这男的发生问题，结果就失去信心，也不来了。
Or we may lose trust in the authorities, the people leading in charge of the center. We may feel, I don't like this guy, I don't like him, you know.Oh, I don't like this way of speaking, he's not friendly, or you don't have trust in him.
还有一种就是说对管理权威失去信心，你不喜欢他讲话的方式，不喜欢他的做法，然后就觉得对他有怀疑啊，就不来了。
So this is one problem, one area in which devotee care is helpful.
那这是其中一个部分啊，就是说在照顾奉献的可以来
The second area, health.
再来另外一个部分是关于健康方面。
We need to be concerned about the devotees taking care of their health.
我们必须要关照到奉献者他们的健康啊什么。
Of course, you're not healthy, then it would be difficult for you to come to temple to do any service.
假如你没有健康身体，你就很难来到庙里来做服务了。
So, we have to look at the different problem. What's wrong? Why are you not well?
我们就要去看啊，为什么你身体哪里，为什么不好，不舒服或怎么了？
Are you getting enough exercise? Are you taking enough rest?
你有足够的运动吗？你睡眠的长短时间恰当吗？
What about your diet? Oh, you take you only have one meal a day. You eat at 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock at night?
你只有一天吃一餐啊，可是呢，你这晚上九点十点才吃那么一餐嘛，这当然不健康。
Yeah, many people like that. They work all day, come home at night, they have the meal.
有些人一整天工作没吃什么餐啊，晚上回家九点十点才吃这个正餐。
It's not healthy.
这样就不健康。
Another problem, health, mental and emotional problem.
另外一个方面的问题就是说一个人精神心意啦。情感情绪方面
，Some people can get very depressed.
有一些很容易变得很沮丧、忧郁。
So much anxiety all the time, so much stress.
有一些呢，常常要面临很多的压力跟焦虑。
Or it may be marriage and their sex relationships.
或者说在婚姻里面的问题，还有就是说在婚姻里面的性行为这一类相关的问题。
Young women have to get married.
年轻的女孩子必须要结婚啊。
Sometimes people get married, they have a divorce, they can't get along, they get divorced. This is a big problem.
有一些人结婚了啦，然后婚姻常常发生问题啦，吵吵闹闹，然后来离婚什么的。
Or just the family, all the they're not divorced, but there's the family problem.
那有一些不离婚，可是一大家庭。
And then taking care of children, also bringing up children is really a difficult thing. It's very challenging, difficult.
然后去所谓不只是教育，而且照顾孩子是非常挑战性的，要很多面临很多常要去注意的事情。
Some people have children. Better you don't come to the temple. Your kid comes and just creates chaos. You know, disturb all the class. We can't do anything.
有一些人的小孩没有好好。或是有什么情况呢？你就会想说叫小孩不要来了，他在那边制造慌乱啊，然后搞得呢大家不能上课或是怎么样。
Then education is also important. You want spiritual education, moral education, many different levels of education.
然后教育方面呢，就很多方面呢，不管是灵性教育啦，或者是说个人啊道德方面的教育，还有文化上面的教育，都有的。
And then some people they're not finding a job. They can't get a job. No work.
那有些人呢，他找不到工作哈，失业在那边慌乱。
They need help.
有一些时候就需要获得帮助。
And then here's another one, financial problems.
再来是说啊，财务方面的问题。
Yeah. Maybe you borrow money from someone, you can't pay it back.
有时候可能你跟谁借钱，没办法还不出去了。
Oh, you have to pay tax to the government. You owe the government a lot of money, taxes.
或者说你跟政府贷款啊，或者说你欠税没缴啦，你要一直去罚款。
Some people may have problems for housing. They haven't got a proper place to live.
有些人居住的房屋有问题啊，一直没有恰当地方可以住啊。
Some of the Indian boys here, they have this problem. They don't get difficult to find a proper place to stay here in Taipei.
有一些印度男孩，也有房屋的问题，他们找不到恰当的地方可以住。
No place, or they get a place, no place to cook.
或是他们找到地方住，但是那个住的地方又没有厨房，不能煮东西。
We do have like in India, and not only in India, other countries also, we have bases. They have these houses, devotees stay together.You know, people who are working in jobs, they stay together. They rent a house and they live together, all devotees. And they can have a morning program together, or they cook together, prasadam together.
在印度还有其他国家也有，就是奉献者之间有一些人他们在外面工作啊，那大家一起租一个地方哈，或是有一个地区，然后他们可以。固定大家每天固定做早课，有地方可以做饭，这样子一起。
Do you have that in Australia?
Yeah, we have a lot of people do that.
Quite a few people do that. They don't do it here in Taiwan. Why not?
为什么这么做？
We should organize that and get some devotees together. You're too much independence, private life. We don't know what you guys are doing every night.
就是说这边应该也要这么做啊，就大家都这么各自独立，不知道你们晚上早上有没有做早课在干嘛？没有人监督。
And then travel, immigration, we spoke about this immigration problem.
还有就是说移民签证这一类的问题，有一些人会面临这种情况。
Lifestyle, the way we live, keep taking care of things.
还有就是生活方式啊，是什么样的状态
？Internet, some people are on the internet 24, they can't stay off the internet all the time. You know, they're using their mobile phones all the time. They can't, you know, they can't put the phone down for a few minutes.
网络啊，比方生活方式啊，有一些没办法离开这个上网啊，一整天不是手机就是电脑，差不多。只要眼睛睁开，都是连在那里。
Yeah, they're not Krishna conscious. They're just mobile conscious.
他们不是 Krishna 知觉，是这个手机啊互联网的知觉。
And then also legal civic problems.
再来是法律上的啦，或者是说所谓公民啊，一个人在一个地区是不是有什么法律上的问题？
And then sometimes mediation, you get problems, you have conflicts, you have difficulties getting along.
还有呢，就要面临有时候需要做调解之商，有时候奉献者之间没办法相处。
So these are 12 different areas of devotee care which we've recognized. Maybe you can yourself suggest more, or maybe you can point out.Which one do you think is the most important from these 12? You know?
也许你们从这十二个方面看到，或者你们自己可以提出来，还有其他哪一些方面是要照顾到，是很重要的。
You know which one is generally, when we ask devotees about this, which one they consider to be the most crucial.
在这十二项大家知道吗？一般我们问到奉献者哪一项是比较，所以比较危急或是比较重要的。
The thing which they feel can really need that help. This mental and emotional problems. even devotees, you know, Krishna conscious devotees, we have the greatest problems with this kind of issues.
那我们看到呢，即便是奉献者呢，还是有这一类关于精神方面的或者情绪感情方面的问题是存在最多的问题。
You even get sometimes we even get suicide cases.
甚至碰到有人自杀。
It's, you know, although we're in Krishna consciousness, and you know, suicide is like the worst thing you can do, but so, sometimes, sometimes it happens.
我们在 Krishna 知觉里面呢，是最不可能这样，但是这最糟糕的事还是发生，还是有人自杀。
So people really need help in that kind of situation.
像这样那一类的情况，就真的他们需要帮助的。
Mental and emotional depression, that they feel so depressed. You know, I know some ladies, you know, even though they're married and they have beautiful children, but they're so depressed all the time, you know. Just, and even this one woman I'm thinking of, she's a doctor. And, you know, she's supposed to be giving comfort and guiding, but she's always, I'm so depressed, I'm so dying.
就我知道，在奉献者有一位女士啊，她总是一直是那种非常沮丧、忧郁。她甚至自己是一个医生，本来是应该去帮助别人、舒缓别人，结果她自己就说：“我一直都是在焦虑、沮丧、在忧郁里面，很难过。”
We have a, it's just the nature of this society, this kind of environment which we're living in.That it creates these kind of problems.
这是就是社会上我们所生存的社会是那样的气氛，那样氛围，总是会有不断的这类的干扰情绪的问题出现。
Any of you have any other particular thing which you consider to be very important? Which
大家那么各位有没有觉得有什么？要去注意的，或是哪些是特别重要的
so all of these things are important, but some of them are, you know, like this one, this health care, more, even more than others.
It's
very special.
当然每一方面都是非常重要，但是关于健康方面，特别是情绪的健康，是更需要注意的。
Okay, any question?
Prabhu, what's your view on sort of implementing, because you mentioned that some, like we're working within the constraints of like, you know, society or the laws and everything, and one of the constraints is the, you know, the way ISKCON's set up and that we're working within that. So in terms of some things like, you know, for example, people that join the temple when we, you know, have this goal of making them, you know, materially sort of comfortable, but it seems like sometimes we're not really structured in that sort of way. We have a mentality of like, the building's on fire, so we got to get out of here and get back to Godhead. So devotees will, that join the temple, they might not sort of,when they're in the ashram, get the necessary tools to be able to, you know, sort of function materially and sort of be prosperous. So do you think that sort of system from a, you know, organizational perspective may require, you know, changes?
Implanting some material assets to help devotees like.
Basically giving more guidance to people materially so that they get situated and that, you know,
yeah,
for example, like education and things like that for devotees that join the temple.
Yeah, he was making the point that sometimes we just only emphasize going back to God. Well, everything else, you know.
Everything is
secondary. It's secondary. First thing is go back to God.
他有一点在也是关心，也是询问。当然啦，是不是在我们在物质方面的设备跟教育，是不是应该多一些关注？比方说，奉献者进来灵修的团体，当然也有一种期望，希望他们在灵性方面有一些改，在物质方面的生活也有一些改善。但是这里几乎都是灵性的方向的，就是说要怎么样离开这个物质世界，回归家园。所以呢，有时候奉献者对物质方面的处理很焦虑，很慌乱，因为没有物质上的引导和教育呢，他们对于面临的物质生活不知道怎么处理。那是不是在这个方面可以有一些加强？比方说教育一个奉献者怎么样在物质方面的工作，或是找，就像刚刚家庭啊、小孩啊、夫妻这些都可以去调整，或是怎么样的指导方针去加强教育。
We have to appreciate what Nimai is saying, that sometimes, you know, depending on who you're hearing from and what kind of preaching is going on around you, you know, sometimes it may appear like that the emphasis is, oh, get out of here, this place is on fire, go back to God.
所以呢，有时候呢，就是我们应该去感激你麦刚刚说的，因为有时候呢，你要去注意你从谁那边去听到的传教，还有那个地区是怎么样在传教或进行。因为有时候我们去跟人家说我们的问题，人家说啊这些不管了啦，反正物质世界我们要赶快离开啦，就像森林大火了啦，不要去管了，赶快往灵性方面啦。但是有时候回头看物质方面。
But the principle of Krishna consciousness is that we can be Krishna conscious in this lifetime. We don't have to go back to Godhead to become Krishna conscious.
所以 Krishna 知觉呢，是我们这一生一世都可以 Krishna 知觉，不见得说等到你回到灵性世界才是 Krishna 知觉。
We can be liberated in this very life.
我们在这一生活着的时候都可以得到解脱。
It's not that we have to be thinking about getting out of this world quick, giving up everything and getting out. That's Buddhism.
所以我们不是说想着说，哦，就是放弃物质生活，回到灵性世界，不是说哦你放弃物质的，我们还是要去面对，不然的话，就像佛教，一切都是虚无的。
Buddhism, Buddha taught that if the house is on fire, you get out.
当然，佛陀说啊，你家里着火就赶快要逃出去嘛，哈。
But Krishna consciousness is put out the fire.
Krishna 知觉教导我们说，怎么样去灭火。
The fire of material existence is extinguished by Krishna consciousness.
物质世界的燃烧的火焰呢，是要经过用 Krishna 知觉把它灭掉。
So we are concerned with the material situation of the devotees.
我们是关心奉献者的处境。
We want to see the devotees are properly situated for their continued spiritual advancement.
我们想要看到是奉献者很恰当的处在身处他的境地是很恰当的，而且可以持续进行他的服务。
We like to see the devotees have a nice lifestyle.
我们想要看到奉献者有好的生活方式。
They can live in the world like ordinary people, and at the same time be Krishna conscious.
他们可以像所谓一般世界上里面的人一样，在世界上好好的活着，同时有着 Krishna 知觉。
You don't think you're a devotee, you have to live under a tree.
我们不会说你是奉献者，就住在树下就好了。
Live like ordinary, like normal people.
Mm-hmm.
But show the example how you can be Krishna conscious.
奉献者呢就要跟一般人一样，这样好好的生活，同时呢要自己是变成模范，让人家知道 Krishna 知觉是的人正好好的生活着。
So devotee care is to help devotees to find their place in the society, both materially and spiritually.
所以关于奉献者，照顾奉献者，就是说照顾奉献者，让他在个人方面，在协会、社会上呢，是很好的立足。
But at the same, you know, keeping their Krishna consciousness.
那照顾这些呢，也是要保持他们的 Krishna 知觉。
No, like.Career and employment, you know, if you can be with Krishna conscious devotees, then it's a great benefit in your daily lifestyle.
所以呢，关于你在事业上的成就呢，你做得很稳当的话呢，也是在 Krishna 知觉是一个很好的助力。
If every day you're selling alcohol or, you know, serving meat, fish and eggs to people, cooking meat, you know, then difficult to eat.
那如果你是在卖烟卖酒，然后每天在卖肉啊、煮肉啊，那你要这样子要成为 Krishna 知觉都很难，要培养别人 Krishna 知觉也很难。
Try to help people get realistic situations so they can live in the material world and all at the same time be Krishna conscious.
所以就是帮助那些人怎么样好好选择他的生活方式，帮助他们这样的生活方式成为 Krishna 知觉。
Okay, so we'll stop here tonight.And next time when we're having class on Wednesday, we'll speak about what kind of people, the different areas, the different sections of our devotees who need devotee care.
那我们今天就先讲到这里。星期三晚上我们再讲到关于哪一各个方面的各种不同的人，然后他们有什么需要，要怎么样去照应。
如果身体就像撞到了，我车祸撞到嘛，啊，现在念曼传曼传，这边越念就会越痛啊，因为撞到是这一边，啊，那可以念左边吗？可是，一般的念珠不是一定要念，可以念这一边吗？你这边越念好痛好痛好痛，每天可以用左边，
可以
哈，谢谢。
Okay, thank you very much.